Excellent performance. The children, please go back to your parents and be seated.
There's several things I'd like to point out. In the South Lounge, Professor Cho has very kindly put up a lot of cultural stuff about China and Chinese customs, about our festivals, and some other achievement of the Chinese throughout history. And also, if you look, there are also several display of artwork and photography which are done by our local community. And please, sometime after dinner and after the program, you are welcome to go take a look. Okay, and there are also. On Chinese New Year, it is very typical for the Chinese to hang up lanterns. And there is a practice in the old days that each lantern would have a riddle. And the reason why is that they want the young men to show off their what they have learned. So all the young men would go around and they would be looking at the lanterns, checking out the puzzles, and showing how quick-witted they are. And meanwhile, the beautiful ladies, the single girls, would be hiding somewhere in the darkness, checking them out, and so are their parents. So it's a way for young people to meet, okay, and get to know each other. As we all know, Chinese guys are very shy. So we have an example of those Chinese readers right in the southeast corner. And you are free to try your luck, because there will be a prize for the person who answers the most questions over there. And also, in the past, the Chinese also has the equivalent of the Western horoscope. So Professor Chow has also very kindly said that, well, he knows how to tell viewers' fortune. So he's going to, he has set up a table right on the southeast corner after the bar is moved, and you can go try your luck there. There would also be a calligraphy demonstration after the program, and you are also welcome to go have your name written in Chinese or just some greeting in Chinese. My husband, Wing Chu, and Ya Su Feng, who is an extremely fine calligrapher, will be the one doing the honors. Okay? That's what I want to remind everybody, because I know that perhaps the evening might be a little late after the program and people will be taking the children home. It's not quite over. We Chinese believe in partying really long, you know, up to the hour of 11:45. Okay. So enjoy your dinner.
The exact date of this Chinese New Year. But this is the first time that we have the Chinese professionals working together with the Chinese Students and Scholar Association to have a Chinese New Year celebration together. That's why we have such an overly large crowd. I hope that by working together, you will see that there is a diversity of range of age in this audience or crowd over here. We have some people who are just fresh off the boat, who just came from China. And then we have people like me who have lived here for over 30 years. And I believe some of you have lived here even longer than I have. Then we have people who are actually born and bred in this country, like my son and so on. They hardly know about Chinese traditions and Chinese culture, and this is a good occasion for them to learn something about Chinese tradition and Chinese culture. We're actually very lucky to be in Champaign, Urbana. I'm always very surprised that we can grow such a great university in the middle of the cornfield. And this is almost like an oasis in the middle of the cornfield, despite the fact that we are very far away from many other cultural centers. We have a very vibrant Chinese community here. I think we have about 200 Chinese families who live here, and there are over 700 or 800 Chinese students who study on this campus. And that brings to the cultural diversity that we have on this campus. Well, let me tell you a little bit about Chinese New Year tradition. I actually grew up in Malaysia, and Malaysia has a sizable Chinese population, so we could keep a lot of the Chinese traditions the way it was done in old China. And I think if you live in Champaign, Urbana, that's kind of hard to do. And I recall that Chinese New Year is always a time for rejoice and jubilation. It was one of the happiest days I had when I was a little child. And I would stay up very late until 12 o'clock to await the coming of the New Year. So the thing is that the Chinese people actually celebrate New Year's for 15 days in olden days. But I believe that we don't have the kind of luxury anymore to celebrate for 15 days. And tonight we only have about 5 hours to celebrate and recall and remember and rejoice over this auspicious day. Actually, it's kind of nice to have so many Chinese people in central Illinois. We Chinese, as we call ourselves, are very ancient people. We have a very different way of looking at things. And I always liken this to a human being growing old. When I was young, I always thought, well, why did my parents like Chinese opera or opera so much? I could never understand why they really like those boring stuff. But as you grow old, you actually change your outlook in life and start to like things that you don't like when you were young, and you savor things differently, and you start to see things that are different. In fact, very recently, I was kind of surprised that my wife became very interested in Chinese opera, something that he would not have an interest in when she was young. So I think that we having a very ancient culture of 4,700 years offer a different perspective into this world compared to other cultures in the world, like America is about 230 years young, while we are 4,700 years old. So for this auspicious day, Professor Wei Chen Chao has prepared Chinese cultural corner and table over there where you can learn something about Chinese culture and how we look at the world. And perhaps you can learn something on from that viewpoint. And also Dr. Yu Wang, or Wang Yu, has also prepared some Chinese arts over there. Let me tell you a little bit about the Chinese New Year banquet tradition that we have on this campus. I think it was probably about 14 years ago, it was in 1990, Andy Lee decided that the Chinese New Year celebration in this town was lackluster, and he together with Hua Li and Professor Casey and Margaret Ye decided to have a Chinese New Year celebration, and since then we have had this celebration for many, many years. So before I stop talking, I'd actually like to acknowledge the past organizers of this meeting, and when I call their name, I hope they can stand up, and please hold your applause till the end of the list of names. I'm going to call Andy Lee. Please hold the applause until the end, okay? Margaret Ye, Susan and Jack Liu, and I have Selena and Tom Chen, Yashu and Milton Fang, Pauline and Monkey Mark, Lexi and Cam Wong, and let me see, I have Alan and David Lin, who actually organized that for 3 years in a sequence, and last year it was Irene and Yi Kui Wei. And please give these people a hand of applause for what they have done in the past in keeping this tradition alive. And since we are organizing this banquet tonight, I also have the honor of inviting my department head, Dick Blehart, and his wife, Barbara Blehart, to come to this banquet, and also my associate department head, Nayarana Rao, and his wife, Sarojini Rao, who are with us this evening. I thank them for coming, and there are a lot of guys, you can see non-Chinese faces and also non-Chinese friends and relatives among the crowd here. So the next thing I'd like to do is actually to invite the important people up here. The reason why I'm speaking up here actually is due to my wife, who has been working tirelessly in the last few weeks to get this thing going. And so she actually is the person behind the show, and she should come up over here. And then she has been helped by her co-chairs, Sherry Chen and John Chen, who should also come up here, I believe. Sherry and John. And also Hong Wei, who is the president of the Chinese Students Scholar Association. And I'd like to let them say a few words and acknowledge those people who helped them.
Here am I again, okay. We're going to get this housekeeping business out of the way. I have a whole slew of people to thank, okay. I'd like to introduce and thank this year's committee. Please stand up and be recognized. Sherry is somewhere around, taking care of things behind the scene, I believe. And of course, there's John and Hong Wei, as Wing said. And I would like to introduce my treasurer, Sarah Lowe. Please, everybody, please hold your applause until, please stand, okay? And everybody hold their applause until I go down this list. Other members who have helped, Josephine Chang, Penny, and Norman Chang. We have we all Penny and Norman a special welcome. Thank you, and also welcome to Norman because he rushed back all the way from Taiwan and was just picked up last night. I don't know how he did it, but he was helping out. Okay, and Susan Chow, Teresa Chow, Professor Wei Chen Chow, Lolita Chuang, Yasu Feng, Ho Shek Fu, Kathy Ito, Andy Lee, Susan Liu, Shirley Shaw, Yu Wang, Jia Wen, and Gary Xu, Myrtle Yang, Randy Yang, Mimi Yao, and then my husband's students at the CEM lab. Okay, and let's see. If I miss anybody, please just excuse me. Okay, but definitely thank you very, very much because you all have been a big help. I don't think I can handle this all by myself. Okay, and I'd like Hong Wei to thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Okay.
Good evening. My name is Wei Hong, the president of CSSA. As you might have heard of, CSSA is one of the biggest student organizations in the University of Illinois. It is our great pleasure to have this opportunity to co-organize this Chinese New Year party with the Chinese New Year Committee. We hope through this activity, our faculty members, students, and all overseas will be able to tighten up our connection and improve our mutual relationship. First of all, I would like to give our gratitude to Mrs. Chu and Mr. Chu for giving us this opportunity to make this event happen. Second of all, I would like to thank Alana Union who provided us the place and setting. We would like to thank our stage manager, Zhenhua Zhang, our sound manager, Fei Cai, our lighting manager, Jie Liu, and our MC, Yan Wang, and Jing Chen. We need to give our special thanks to all the performers for their hard work they have contributed to this event. Finally, we would like to thank all the audience for being here today. We hope all of you enjoy the night as much as I do. Thank you very much.
Hello, my name is Sherry Chen. First of all, we'd like to thank you the following people for their generous cash and the door prize contributions. Please stand as you are named. First of all, it's the CACI represented by KL Yan, 2004 Chairman of the Board, and the Professor Wen Cho, outgoing Chairman of 2003, Castle Apartment, the owner of the Weijie and the Suyi, and also Kennedy's Restaurant. And another one is the Hans Beauty Salon, Global System Information, the President, Mr. Tom Chen and Mrs. Selena Chen, and also Suzanne and Jack Liu, Dr. Ming Wen, Penny and Norman Chen, Mandarin Walk Restaurant, and the Miko Restaurant, and Mr. Paul Chen's Oriental Mart, and Irene and Kathy Ito. Thank you very much. Would you guys please stand up so we can clap for them? Thank you very much.
Yeah, at this moment, I'd like to invite Ethan Chu and also Eva Chen to come up to present something to our host, Sherry Chen, and also Chichen, my wife. Ethan, can you please come up? And Eva, can you please come up? Thank you very much. But the next part of the program is actually to have a keynote speaker, Professor Georgie, come in here to see a few things. Professor Georgie is the director of the East Asian Studies Center that we have at the University of Illinois. Formerly, he was also the head of the political science department. He has organized a lot of cultural activities in the Champaign-Urbana area. He works overseas with universities like Kamkang University in Taiwan. He works with Ford Foundation and also some foundation in Chicago to promote a lot of cultural activities. I'd like him to come up to give the keynote speech. I don't know where Professor George Yu is. Yes, let's welcome him for the keynote speech that's going to give to us.
Thank you very much. I'm very pleased to be here. I would like you to, first of all, join with me in extending a very warm thanks to the co-chairs of this year's Planning Committee, Dr. and Mrs. Chu. This is not an easy event to organize, especially this is the first year that they have held it here on such a massive scale. And so we are all very appreciative of the long hours that they have spent. Certainly, I hope we will continue to have such events in the future. I can well recall of when our family first moved to Champaign-Urbana some 38 years ago. I should say 38 plus years ago, because this is 2004, that New Year's celebration was primarily a family affair where a small number of Chinese and Chinese-American families would gather at respective homes to ring in the New Year, complete with home bao for the children and long life noodles for the adults. But not that the adults were not interested in home bao also. As the number of Chinese and Chinese American in the area grew, so did the number and size of the gatherings until, as we heard, 5 or 10 years ago, a community-wide gathering was finally initiated. Over the years, many of us have participated in the celebrations organized by various, as we heard, New Year's committee, for which we extend our great thanks for their time and effort. Every year, the events seem to get bigger and bigger and better, bringing together the growing number of local Chinese and Chinese-American community. We have had a blast, at least as far as I'm concerned, celebrating our rich heritage, eating well, and meeting new and old friends, and just having plain fun. I expect gatherings like this will continue and grow, if for no other reason than the number of Chinese and Chinese Americans will continue to grow in Champaign-Urbana. We can all be assured of continued celebration of the Chinese heritage. But I'm also glad to see, as we grow each year, we have a greater diversity in terms of those who are present. But I would like to suggest to future New Year planning committees and to all of us present here that we take these celebrations to the next step, namely that we be proactive, namely actively reach out to invite participation from the larger Champaign-Urbana community, not just the university, but the community at large, to these events, to use the occasion both to introduce, to the non-Chinese and to the Chinese American community the richness of the Chinese culture and heritage, and to establish new linkages. We do not live in isolation of the larger environment. Neither should we shy from being part of and refrain from participating in the affairs of the whole of Champaign Urbana. This is a challenge I think all of us can meet as individuals, as a group. We can start by opening up and sharing with the larger Champaign Urbana community future Chinese New Year celebrations and other things. Permit me to close my remarks by saying it has been an honor to speak this evening, and I wish you all 新年快乐, 恭喜发财, and happy year of a monkey. Thank you very much.
Basically, you have to draw about more than one, because we have to, you know, keep this program going. So you can pick three. Okay.
The number I have here is 835791. I repeat, 835791. Who's the lucky ticket holder? Please come here.
Well, I think we are really lucky to be in Champaign-Urbana because there are a lot of people with very latent talent in this town, and the next performer is one of such person. She's Ying Yang, or Yang Ying, depending on how you call her name. She studied Erhu when she was 5 years old, and at the age of 25, she won the best Erhu player prize in China. And since she has played for very many different kinds of important people in China, including three U.S. presidents. She has played for Richard Nixon, Jimmy Carter, and Gerald Ford. She often travels throughout Asia to perform. More recently, actually, she became very interested in Western music, and she was the first person to have started an all-female rock band in China called Cobra. And Cobra actually became very successful, and they actually had a stadium-sized performance in China for the first time. And so Ying Yang actually combines her talent by actually nurturing or combining many Western elements into her music playing. But I think today, just for this occasion, she's going to play some traditional music. And she will be accompanied by Zhang Jingfeng, Zhang Jingfei or Jingfei Zhang, who actually is a student at the University of Illinois. She is studying for the Doctor of Musical Arts, and she specializes in flute performances. And accompanying is only, I guess, her hobby. And we are glad to have her accompany Ying Yang on this performance. And she's from the beautiful island of Taiwan. And so let both of them show you what they can do. I'll hand over the floor to them. called the Sunman Gorge Capriccio. I'm sorry, I forgot to mention the name of the tune just now.
We have a special performer tonight. And she used to be the headmistress of a Chinese school, and now is a mom of two children and a wife of a famous professor here in the ECE department. She's a dancer, she's a painter, and she's a very successful lady. And tonight she's gonna perform us a solo dance, and it is choreographed by herself. And the music piece is called Eternal Love, which is excerpted from the movie Crouching Tiger and Hidden Dragon. So let's welcome Mrs. Lei Zhang Shanbeck. I'd like to invite Mrs. Hermia Su to come up on the stage. Mrs. Hermia Su is a very established member of the community. She is also a piano teacher and has been teaching piano for the very longest time. And of course, I believe everybody knows who Professor Su is. He is also a long time member of this community. Okay? Yeah. Okay. Come in.
Anybody?
You're probably wondering why there's so many people over there. That's for a purpose. So for the next performance, you're going to hear four Taiwanese folk songs arranged for cellos and piano. The first piece is Waiting for Spring Breeze, the second is Joys and Sorrows of Youth, the third piece is Four Seasons, and the last one is Oyster Woman.
And the cellos are going to perform by Peter Su, Danielle Zhou, Timothy Lee, Claire Liu. Piano is going to perform by Sylvia Liu. And Oyster Woman's performed by Liang Liu and Darren Liu. Enjoy.
Hi, my name is Sylvia Liu. I'm a cello teacher in town, and these are just some of my students with a little Chinese background. And so I thought for today's occasion, I prepared just four simple folk tunes arranged for this purpose. The first three are going to be performed by these four here. And the last one, because my husband, who really wanted to show off his very little knowledge of cello, so, and I also just wanted to let you all know that he's not my student, he's my daughter's student. So if he doesn't sound so good, it's really, you know, not my doing. But anyway, he and my son, my six-year-old son, will only play the very last piece. That's just to clarify what's on the program. So these four are real pros. So don't expect too much for the last piece.
Thank you.
Well, the next performance is going to be a Tai Chi performance. Tai Chi performance, or Tai Chi Quan, is a martial art that's based on Taoist philosophy. And Taoist philosophy is at least 2,000 years old. I have heard Westerners who practice Tai Chi wrote passionately about this art. And they liken Tai Chi as something that the Chinese culture has contributed to this world, which is a duel. Taoist philosophy is confounding, hard to understand. And Tai Chi Quan is often practiced by scholars and artists in China because of its confounding principle, which is sometimes quite profound. The next performer is going to be Master Yang Yang, who runs a center for Tai Chi study at Champaign Urbana. Again, he brings to the cultural richness of the central Illinois region. Actually, I'm taking lessons from him, so I know quite a bit about Tai Chi. Master Yang Yang is actually started learning Tai Chi when he was young due to his illness. And he studied with several grandmasters in China, such as Feng Zhiqiang and Chen Zhaokui. And also, he actually won the Chinese Martial Art Championship for quite a few years. And in 1985, he was voted as the best overall martial artist in China. He actually studied law and engineering in China, and after having come to the US, he's currently studying in the Department of Kinesiology, and currently he's studying for his PhD. I will let Master Yang Yang perform next and enjoy the performance. I'd like to mention that Yang Yang and Yang Ying actually
are siblings.
They're all from the Yang family. The Yang family is very talented, and we are really, really lucky to have that family in central Illinois. And I'd like to introduce Mr. Yang Ruiwu,
who is
the parents of both Yang Yang and Yang Ying, and also Madam Liu Dehua. And thank you very much for bringing culture to central Illinois.
I'd like to invite Yang Ying to please come up and do the next drawing, please. Thank you.
Shoot. 835522.
Come.